Let's go to John in Philly. Hey, John, what's going on, brother?
Good morning, Tom. And Tommy, thanks for taking the call.
Absolutely.
Morning,
man.
John.
Say, Tom and Tommy, I wanted to ask if you could give me some of your input regarding GDX. That ETF is currently trading right at 33. It's pulled back in the past couple of weeks, and it is, at least at this moment in time, bouncing off and above 32. And, you know, I look at 32 as being potentially pivotal in that that was the high of 2016 and then of February this year. Is that important? Does that mean anything to you? And can you just give me your GDX input on what you envision the next significant move?
Absolutely. So stay right there. We're going to take a quick break, folks. We'll come back. We're going to be talking gold, silver equities. We'll be talking the metals in general. Dow. Dow right now up to 779. NASDAQ's up 229. S&P's are up 78. We'll come right back. Welcome back, folks. Dow. Dow's up 806. NASDAQ's up 231. S&P's are up 79. We're talking with John from Philly. We're talking about the GDX. So the GDX, you know, in general, John, okay, this consolidation has been going on since April 7th. You know, we rejected lower price yesterday, so I'd say that, okay, you know, you can't bust them down, they're going to try to bust them up again. That's how this is set up, man. You know, I would like to see right here today, is if we look at it, what you're going to see is this, is that what happened yesterday, folks, is that we go down, it rejected price. And what we've just done here, if I bring a few of the bigger ones up, what you're going to see is that we're actually just pulled back to where it had strength yesterday. Like if we look at Barrick had some strength at 24.51. We hit 24.26 this morning. We're at 24.24. Newmont the same way. You know, so that's telling me that the setup's not perfect right now, but we both know, and if you've been in the gold or silver market for a while, folks, okay, when you reject price, whether it's at the highs or the lows, the risk now would be not being in it. That's my take on it because of the fact that we rejected it, and I think the top of the range is game now.
Great. I was thinking exactly the words that you just mentioned. The setup's not quite perfect right here, but I appreciate that input of yours, Tom, and we'll see where it goes from here.
All right. And as we know, because what happens here, folks, is this, and John knows this, these setups, as particularly in the gold market, when they're really great, it's awesome. But there's many times that they're just off a bit, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, it goes boom, you know. And, you know, what I've seen is that, like right now, this is the first time in a long time we've been positioned in silver stocks. And even out of the gold report, I'm realizing, okay, I got four silver stocks and I don't have one gold stock. So it's pretty intriguing. Do you know what I mean? Because it could have been really bad yesterday. But that's telling me also that if, in fact, the silver stocks are stronger than the gold stocks, that's a big plus, man, because silver has been the laggard for a long period of time. I mean, it picked its head up, you know, a couple months ago, but the silver market in general, folks, has been basically keeping that metals market down because the volatility is vicious, man. There's no doubt, you know.
Very good. Thanks so much for your help. I appreciate
it. Cooking, brother. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.